The Honourable John King, Prime Minister, Honourable Anne Tolley, Minister of Education, Honourable Finlayson, Attorney General, Honourable Peter Dunn, Minister of Revenue, Lucinda Ardern, MP, Tim Clark, Jan Blair from Russell Bay, Councillor Ian McKinnon, Deputy Mayor of Wellington, Claire Ryan, President of the Royal Schools Debating Council, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we are here this afternoon to celebrate the achievements of the 2008 Russell Bay New Zealand Schools Debating Team, the winners of the 2009 World Schools Debating Championships. You'll hear more about the achievements in a moment, but for now it's my pleasure to introduce the host of tonight's event, Prime Minister, the Honourable John King.
Colleagues that are here this evening. Can I also acknowledge Claire Ryan, the Chair of the World Schools Debating Council, obviously Chris in his capacity as President of the New Zealand Schools Debating Council, but in particular, can I welcome the World Championship New Zealand team, Maria and Lee. Certainly deserve a clap. Maria English, Tom Chen, Holly Jenkins, Ben Cornfield and Jennifer Savage. I've got to tell you actually, you're in firstly one of my favourite rooms in Parliament, Grand Hall. I think it's a fantastic room. It's a great place to celebrate success. Secondly, I feel immensely nervous actually, being around so many debaters, knowing that Maria can rebut my speech after I've given it. All those things are putting me on the spot. But we're here because we want to celebrate the fact that the New Zealand team won the World Championships in Athens. They beat teams from 39 countries. We hadn't won since 1995, and it was a remarkable achievement. And I think everyone who was in the team or associated with the team should feel immensely proud of those achievements, and I really want to say how great it is to be here to be able to celebrate that opportunity. I know that you had lots of rounds to get there, and I know that you were tested on a wide range of topics. If you like debating, as I'm sure the New Zealand team absolutely does, it's a shame you weren't here on Friday and Saturday to midnight. We were looking forward to a lot of help, and actually by the end of it, a few ideas, but I know that you have those skills and you're going to be able to take them into the future in whatever you do. And I think the ability to be able to mount an argument, to be able to think on your feet, and to be able to win the day through those sort of verbal combat are skills that you'll be able to take into the future, and it's going to put you in great stead, so we're very proud of you. I do want to acknowledge the coaches for the team, because they, like the team members, are hugely important in terms of achieving that success. So Kevin Moore and Julia Featherston, and the team manager, Kevin Moore and Rosie Moore, I understand that Kevin and Rosie also work for government agencies, so it's great to hear we've got such a job, actually. I don't know if you work for DPMC, but if you don't, you could be by this afternoon. I'd be there to help. Can I acknowledge everyone that supported the team, but in particular Russell McVeigh, who, without their support, financial support and the likes, wouldn't have allowed the team to travel to Athens. So, just to the individual team members, can I tell you that, firstly, it's a remarkable achievement to make the New Zealand team. And I think that's something that you'll always remember. It's a fantastic feeling to be able to stand up and to know that you have been selected because you're the best at what you do and the particular passion that you have. And then to go to the World Champs, such a long way away in Athens, Greece, is itself a remarkable set of memories and ones that you'll always have. And then to get through to the kind of quarterfinals and the semi-finals and ultimately the finals of themselves would be a fantastic achievement. But in the end, to know that you were the world champions, that you were the best in the world, and that you represented New Zealand with such great pride makes us all very, very proud of you. And I remember when the news came through and I saw it in the paper, there was a lot of hooting and hollering going on around here. And we also knew that the future of New Zealand debate was in great stead. So I do want to congratulate you and wish you the very best. I've been talking to a few of you, and I know that you're embarking on your university educations as a general rule. So all the best for that. Go well. I would say break a leg, but we're really sort of so you'll understand what I mean. But it's great to be here and to be part of the celebrations. And I think on that note, Maria, you want to say anything? Okay,
real.
Secondary Schools Debating Council, Chris Bishop, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. There's an ancient tradition in the practice of law that whenever young people do something brilliant and notable, such as Maria, Tom, Holly, Ben and Jennifer have here, older people, learned in the law and in life, gather around and claim credit. But that's not the tradition I'd like to invoke this evening. The tradition I, on behalf of partners of Russell McVeigh, would like to call on this evening is the tradition of the free exchange of, and debate of ideas. That tradition, as you all know, is one of the most noble of all human achievements. It underpins much of what we are proud of in modern society. And you don't need to look too far from our shores here in New Zealand to see the consequences of its diminishment. Debating, or rhetoric as known by the ancients, is one of the pillars of that tradition. And that is why we are proud as a law firm to support the development of young people growing and indeed demonstrating their skills in this ancient art. Without wanting to place a hex on the team members by resigning you to future careers in law or in politics, I offer you our warmest congratulations on your success. It bodes well for your future contribution to society. The skills you have so obviously excelled in will stand you in good stead, whatever path and walk of life you indulge in. Although one of my good friends and former debating colleagues suggested that there's one area that you shouldn't practice those skills in, which is the area he calls domestic administration. So I offer Maria, Tom, Holly, Ben and Jennifer the warmest congratulations of Ruffin Bay, and I wish you all the best in the future debates that lie ahead.
Thank you, Tim. On behalf of New Zealand Schools Debating Council, the organisation which I head, I'd like to thank the Prime Minister for hosting this afternoon's function and this wonderful venue of Parliament. The Council has had a long and happy association with Parliament since we were established as an organisation in 1988. Every year, the final of the National Championships, as many of you will know, is hosted just next door in the Legislative Council Chamber. The host of the final for many years now has been the Honourable Peter Dunn. I see he's just left, but I was going to say thank you, Peter, for the role that you play in making schools debating happen in New Zealand. The Head of State of New Zealand, the Governor-General, is the patron of the New Zealand Schools Debating Council and traditionally attends the final of the championships. However, they don't always stay for all of the final. On one famous occasion in 1989, the Governor-General at the time, Sir Paul Reeves, had to abruptly leave the final after being called back to Government House at the request of the Prime Minister. I'm told that all the participants eagerly listened to National Radio's midday report to find out what political calamity had befallen the Prime Minister in taking the Governor-General away, and it turned out to be the resignation of David Longley as Prime Minister. Longley, of course, was the greatest parliamentary debate in New Zealand has known, so I think there's perhaps some symmetry there. We now have our first alumna of the organisation in the House of Representatives themselves. I'm sure many more debaters will go on to join Jacinda Ardern in Parliament, and I'm sure there'll be many debaters on both sides of the aisle. Jacinda was a debater for Waikato in 1997 at the National Championships and later coached the team for many years. Finally, in closing, I'd like to thank our sponsors, Ruskin Bay, again. It's true that many, probably too many debaters go on to become lawyers, but Ruskin Bay support, as you've heard from Tim, goes beyond simply sponsoring debating to attract the top law students. Russell McVeigh knows that the skills that debating teaches, which are arguments based on logic, reason and evidence, and the power of the spoken word to move and persuade, and the skills of critical analysis, they know that those skills are essential in civil society and for the contribution to an enlightened and informed population. So thank you very much for coming, everybody. That draws the evening to a close. Thank you for coming, as I say. Please stay and catch up, with friends old and new. The function will continue for some time. It's great to have you all here. Thank you again to the Prime Minister for hosting us. And thanks very much. May New Zealand win their fifth title next year in Qatar. Yeah.